So far, we've added properties to individual document types and rendered these values on the front end. Sometimes there might be some fields that we would want to show on all pages. These fields might be the same, but its value might be different. By using compositions, we can use the same properties on multiple document types at the same time. This is how a front end looks currently. The About Umrako page has a banner with the title and the subtitle that says Welcome Umrako TV. And if we look at the Contact Us page, it's exactly the same, even though these pages are based on two different document types. Well, actually, both these fields are defined in the master template. Let's take a look at the master template. In the master template, if we look at the Jumbotron with title section, you'll notice that the title and the subtitle are entered from here. We want to create properties that will allow us to add different values based on the content page. We want to add dynamic values. For this, we are going to use compositions. By using compositions, we can use the same properties on multiple document types at the same time. Let's go to the homepage document type up here. There's a button here called compositions. The text in here says, a composition inherits tabs and properties from an existing document type. That's exactly what we need. Right now, we cannot select any of our existing document types. This is because they both contain a property with a body text alias. It's not possible to have two properties on the same document type using the same alias. The alias must be unique. So, that means we'll need to create a new document type. Let's start by adding a folder and calling it Compositions. In the folder, we'll create a new document type called Composition. This is exactly what we need. Let's add in some properties and values here. We'll call this Title Box. We'll add a group and call it Title Box as well. In this group, we'll need two properties here. The first one will be a title, and we'll add a text string editor to it. And the second property will be a subtitle. And for this one, we'll use a text area. And save our composition. Let's go back to our homepage document type and add the composition. In the homepage document type here, click on compositions and we'll add our new document type from here and submit it. And as you can see, the entire group with the two properties is now added to our homepage document. And if we save the homepage and go to the content section, you'll see that we now have two new fields to fill in. All right, let's do that real quick. In the title, I'll add Try the Friendly CMS Today. And in the subtitle, I'll add Creating and Updating Your Website Should Be the Least of Your Worries. Let's save and publish the content. So for these values to be rendered on the front end, we need to make some changes to our master template. Let's go to our master template. In the master template, we'll look for the Jumbotron with title section and highlight the text, Welcome Umrako TV. Click on Insert, Select Value, and from the drop-down, we'll find our title property. Let's use this configuration options. We already used the default value in the earlier videos. For this property, we are going to make it recursive. This means that there will be a fallback added to the property and it will fall back to the ancestors. If you have a content page without the title value filled in, it will simply take the value filled in on the parent node. In our case, that would be the welcome home page. All right, we'll submit this value. And do the same for the subtitle here. We'll highlight the text, click Insert, Value, and select the subtitle property and make it recursive. Cool. Let's check out the front end now. We'll go to the home page, click on the Info tab, and select the link. And as you can see, it's now rendering the values that we put in the content section. Let's add this composition to the Contact Us page. Go to Settings, Contact Us page, and add the composition. Save it. Let's see what happens if we refresh our Contact Us page. So now it gives us the same content as we entered on our home page. That's because we haven't filled in these values in the Contact Us page. Let's go to the Content section, Contact Us page, and add these values. Cool. Let's save and publish and refresh the Contact Us page. And there we go. So we can either fill in our own title and subtitle for each content page or leave it blank. And it will always inherit from the parent node. In our case, the home page. And that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll walk through another important feature, that is creating blogs or articles. So see you in the next video.